notice a broken sound. And after we do a shvarim, we go back to the straight sound of a tkiya. Tkiya, rak tkiya.
We're privileged this evening to study Parashat Ha'azinu. And one of the sentences which is outstanding in the Torah section of this week, in our Parashat HaShavua, we read in the fourth sentence of our section, Ki chol derechav mishpat, for all of God's ways are just. There are so many people in the world who have so many questions on the justice or the so-called lack of justice that they experience or that they see in the world. Maybe the answer is in the word kol. Kol drachav mishpat. All of God's ways are just. It means if you feel that you can understand the justice of God just by looking at one particular event, at one particular event, at one particular happening, and you ask, so why? In what sense is this just? This doesn't seem to be just. What you're missing is, kol drachav mishpat, tzadik Hashem, b'chol drachav. You want to understand how God is so righteous? Then you have to study all of God's ways. B'chassid, b'chol ma'asav. When will you understand the great piety of God? When you study its entirety. We are so limited in our scope. Of course we don't always see the Mishpat. Because we see drachav, but we don't see kol drachav. It's as if one is studying a painting. I didn't take many courses in college in art, but I took at least one. And we were sent to analyze a painting. I think it was in the Metropolitan Museum of Art. And I went with my notebook and I walked up to the picture and I was staring at like one part of it and someone tapped me on the shoulder. That's not the way you look at a picture. You're going to look at one point of the picture, you're not going to see anything.
Kol tmuna.
Kol drachav mishpat. Step back. See the entire picture. And perhaps that's the mistake that we make in trying to understand God, in that as human beings we're so limited. Perhaps that's not only the mistake that we make in studying God. Maybe it's the mistake that we make in studying other people also. In the chapters of the fathers we study, have they done et kol ha'adam l'chav zchut. Judge all people favorably is the way most people translate that teaching. But that's not what it says, I don't think. It doesn't say have they done et kol adam l'chav zchut, which would mean judge all people favorably. It says, Kol Ha'adam. It's a very refined
book. Each person individual.
Kol Ha'adam.
Yeah, each person individual.
Could be. Or Kol Ha'adam, maybe the entirety of the person. Maybe you really want to judge someone. Maybe you have to know something about their complete self. Why is it that we condemn so many people? Why is it that we look down upon so many people? Because we saw a particular action of theirs. Because, we saw them involved in this kind of activity or not being involved in that kind of activity. Do you know the whole story? Do you know the person? Do you know the kol ha'adam? Maybe we have to be slow in judgment. Hevu mitunim badin. Be deliberate in judgment. Generally understood to mean be slow in judging other people in a courtroom. Maybe being slow to judge other people in the courtroom of life. And maybe being slow in judging God. Kol drachav, what do you know about God? You saw something. Did you see the whole picture? And so many people condemn other people. They meet them at a certain point in life and they're not sweet to them. They're not friendly to them. And they had a meeting with them this afternoon and they were rude, God forbid. So they come to conclusions. Oh, this person is... Do you know what happened 5 minutes before you walked into that office? Do you know anything about this person's life? They're 40 years old. Let's assign, one chapter to every year of life. Let's say they live at least 120. They have 120 chapters in their book. You want to start reading a book with chapter 40? Have fun. Try to understand what's going on. You missed the first 39 chapters. You don't know what's going on. And I believe that that's what's meant in the prayers that we're saying so frequently this week, the week of repentance, in the Slichot services, where we keep mentioning the attributes of mercy of God, and most of them are readily understood, at least superficially. Rachum, Gashem, Hashem, Kel, Rachum, Chanun, Erech Apayim, Rav Chesed. God is merciful and kind and compassionate and slow to anger. All pretty much understood. The one that was always intriguing and difficult to understand is the one called Emet. Emet! One of the 13 principles, one of the 13 attributes of the mercy of God is Emet, truth. Now doesn't truth seem to be maybe the antithesis of mercy? Truth, the person really did what they did. That's truth, that's not mercy. Mercy is okay, they did what they did, but we'll overlook, we'll forgive. Or we'll understand, or we'll explain mitigating circumstances.
You don't look for stuff.
So, emet means, according to one interpretation, what'd you say?
You don't look for stuff against the guy.
That's emet?
Yeah.
Could be. Which letter of the alphabet is emet?
Aleph.
And then?
Beis. And then? Mem.
What's mem? Where's mem of the alphabet?
Middle.
And tav?
And?
So maybe emet is like kol drachav. Maybe the difference between a human court and the court of God is that when a judge decides, they're only allowed to see what the person did now. The here and now. Ein l'dayan, ella ma she'inav ro'ot. But in the judgment of God, God looks at the Aleph, the very beginning of the action. What was happening before? What led the person to do this? What went on in their life? The Aleph, the Mem. What's happening now? The Tav. What is the result of this action? What's going to be in the future? Where are they headed? And maybe if we learn to be on a level of imitatio dei, of trying to seek different ways of kol derachav, then indeed each of us will understand Hatsur Tamim Pa'alo Ki Chol Derachav Mishpat. May we learn to carry out this practice both in our understanding of the divine as well as in our understanding of other people that we encounter in our lives. Thank you so much for listening. Shana Tova Umetuka, the sweetest year, without any strict judgment, just a year of sweetness, happiness, good health, and success. Thank you. Shalom. Shana Tova. It's okay. Mishabarech Avotena Ram Yitzchak Yaakov Moshe Aaron David Shlomo V'imotenu Sarah Rivka Rachel V'Leya V'yivarech V'yirape V'yichazek V'yitzor V'yishmar Et Yirmiyahu Ben Priva Nechama V'et Sarah Shirel Bat Lorraine Elna Rafana Lahem HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yimalei Rachamim Aleihem Lachlimam Lerapotam לחזיקם, לחיותם, וישלח להם מהירה, רפואה שלמה מן השמיים, לכל עבריהם, לכל גידיהם, בתוך שאר חולי ישראל.
תקיעה, שברים, תקיעה.
לא, לבד.
תקיעה, שברים, תקיעה.